Grammy at Oscar-nominated singer-songwriter. Boses at utak sa likod ng mga 70s at 80s hit songs. Na on and on.
On and on, he just keeps on trying.
Separate lives.
Oh, it's so typical. Love leads to isolation.
At it might be you.
Something's telling me it might be you. It's telling me it might be you. All of my life.
Makalipas ang ilang dekada, patuloy pa rin inaawit ng mga Pinoy ang kanyang mga kanta. Ngayon ay nasa Pilipinas para magtanghal para sa kanyang Pinoy fans.
Kaibigan, Steven Bishop. Welcome to the program.
Thank you.
Welcome home.
Yeah, it's kind of home like to you. This is my ninth trip, so.
What makes you keep on coming back?
Well, I love the Filipino people. They really love my songs. It's like a fantastic thing. And I've got actually more hits here than in the States, which is amazing, you know?
How different an audience is a Filipino audience from all the audiences that you've had around the world?
Well, they're just very, very sweet, nice audiences, that I play to. They're
who
just
sings
good
along
people.
With you.
They sing along, and boy, do they like It Might Be You. It's just, they love that song.
That's right. You and I were singing together. And you're doing concerts. Okay, yeah. Let's go to the concerts. Back to back to back. This is with Michael Johnson.
Right.
Joe Puerta of Ambrosia, Side A
Ambrosia.
Band. Okay.
I played with them early on when I, like, one of the first times I was here.
Okay. Let me help you because this is October 18 at the Araneta Coliseum.
Right.
October 26, University of Southern Philippines in Davao City. And October 27, Lagao Gym in General Santos City. Wow. This is a treat for many of your fans in the country. And thank you again for being here. I just wanted to talk about the story that even before you started to sing, you were playing the clarinet.
Oh, yeah.
And you wanted to become a history teacher.
Right, right.
Okay.
Well, I started, I started playing clarinet around 10. I got into an orchestra in my school. And, I just started getting into music. But when the Beatles came along and the Stones, I would try and, do a song of theirs on my clarinet, I Can't Get No Satisfaction by the Stones. I can't get no satisfaction. But it sounded so terrible on clarinet. It was like, doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo. You know, so
okay.
I couldn't impress the girls that I wanted to impress.
At least at that time.
That's
but
right.
Something happened when you were watching the Ed Sullivan show. Is it true? Or is this,
yeah.
Is it true?
Yeah.
You were
all
watching
all of a sudden
the
Beatles on Ed Sullivan, and I just became a giant fan and still am an incredible fan. I'm a Beatleholic.
A Beatleholic. That's nice. Let's talk about some of your biggest hits. Let's talk about the songs that have become the soundtrack of the lives of many, not just in this country, but around the world. Let's talk about On and On. What's the story? I mean, just very, just briefly.
On and On is kind of just a colorful song about, you got to keep on trying, even when it looks bad. And should I sing a little?
Please.
On and on, I just keep on trying. And I smile when I feel like crying. On and on, on and on, on and on.
Just move on. Just keep on trying. And whatever happens.
Yeah.
That's a very positive song.
Yeah.
Let's go to the next one, Separate Lives. I mean, what is the story?
Well, that's...
You wrote this song.
That's a different kind of a song. That song I wrote with by myself, but I wrote it about a break. It was a breakup song. I was...
An experience of a friend? I mean,
this girl that I lived with and everything, and we had this giant relationship. and when we broke up, it was just really tough. And I was in this hotel, and she called me, and she said, "How you doing?" And I said, "You have no right to ask me how I feel." And that became the chorus.
How long did you write the song, Separate Lives?
How long did it take?
I mean, how long did it take?
A night.
Really? I mean, do you start with the words, Mr. Bishop, or do you start with a melody?
I actually start with the title. I mean, that's the way I like it.
Okay,
I mean,
you start with a title, and
yeah,
then you
if
start...
I get a title, it's almost like half the song is written, you know.
Okay, I mean, just the words just follow.
It really helps.
Okay.
But if you know, mostly I start with most of the time I just noodle around on guitar and you know, just come up with something, and then I. You know, right.
And a few lines from Separate Lives.
Oh, sure. Let's see. You have no right to ask me how I feel. You have no right to speak to me so kind. I can go on holding on to ties. Now that we're living separate lives.
Now we know why you have no right got into the lyrics
yeah,
of the song
yeah,
because of that question.
I'm not sure if I've said that before, but it's true. It's a true story.
Okay, but we can't do this interview without you having to do us a few lines from It Might Be You.
Oh, wait a minute.
It Might Be You.
I've heard of that song.
Okay.
Let's see. Time, I've been passing time, watching trains go by. All of my life, lying on the sand, watching seabirds fly, wishing there would be someone waiting home for me. Something's telling me it might be you. Yeah, it's telling me it might be you. All of my life.
Wow. Written by?
Written by Alan and Marilyn Bergman and Dave Grusin.
And you sang this for the movie?
I sang it for the movie Tootsie.
Wow, Mr. Bishop, thank you.
As we say
it here, maraming salamat. Once again, mga kaibigan, back to back. Mr. Bishop with Michael Johnson, Joe Puerta of Ambrosia and Side A Band, October 18, Araneta Coliseum, and October 26, University of Southern Philippines in Davao City, and October 27, Lagao Gym in General Santos City. Last question. I mean, I just wanted to ask you this. I mean, very often we say, if you were given a chance to write your epitaph, how would it go? I'm going to say tonight, can you sing your epitaph?
I was a neat guy. I was really an incredible person. I was someone you should know. Hey, I'll probably come back soon. Okay, I don't know.
Thank you very much, Mr. Bishop.
Thank
Steven
you.
Steven Bishop, ikaw na.
No, boy, it might be you.
Wow.
Ikaw na.